Good evening. We are here at the Washington Golf and Country Club in Arlington, Virginia, because it's PGA Mid-Atlantic Hall of Fame night. I'm Wayne Viener. That's Bruce Posner. And our host, the famous Terp, the famous golfer, Fred Funk.
How you doing?
Bruce?
Freddie.
Hey, guys.
When I found out that I won the award for the Earl Helen Award for Media Guy of the Year, they said, and guess who won the Hall, you know, guess who's entering the Hall of Fame? And they said, Fred Funk. I said, the fix is in. I always been a big admirer of yours.
Thank you.
What is this? I know this means the world to me. I never expected it whatsoever. What does going into the Mid-Atlantic Hall of Fame mean to you?
Well, it's something back in the day I would have never imagined that I would qualify for such a thing or be nominated for it or be inducted. So it's very humbling in one aspect, but an honor at the same time because it is my home. I really got my roots here in the Mid-Atlantic section and playing the pro-ams and playing the Mid-Atlantic championships, and everything that I did here competitively was something I really cherish the memories. And I did move on to the PGA Tour, but I couldn't have done it without what I experienced and how I kind of just rose my level of competition, the competitiveness, while playing in the Mid-Atlantic section. So it was very important.
Go back to the 82 when you were here at College Park, coaching at College Park. What was your ascent onto the tour and then onto the senior tour? It was a short sentence.
Well, there's no such thing as a short sentence. It was a long journey, but 82, the very end of 81, I took over. So 82 was my first full year, and I was coaching guys that were my teammates, and that was impossible. Impossible, because I was one of them 2 years prior to that, and now all of a sudden I'm the coach and the disciplinarian, so-called disciplinarian, and I didn't have much of that. But I started, my game, 82, it wasn't ready to go, and 84, I won the national assistance, and then that kind of started a three-year period where I played really well, and I thought I was ready for the tour in 86, but I tore a rotator at Woodmont Country Club playing in a pro-am, and that shot me back a little bit, took me back about 2 years, and then I qualified for the tour. So it was a long journey and a very unusual journey. Most people don't do what I did and then make the tour. They usually make the tour early and then they fall back to coaching, so I did it in reverse. But it was something that it just took me a long time to mature and get confidence in my game.
What was the moment, what was the event where you actually got your tour card? How did that come about?
Well, I had to go to Q School. So everybody had to go to the Q School back then, and there was back then two stages. And I had never made it to the finals in 84, 5, and 6, I got hurt. But 88, I made it to the final, and I made it for the first time. And I made it to the final, and then I made it. I did lose my card in my first year, and I had to go back to Q School, and I made it, and then I never had to go back. So it was a long journey.
Does that,
I
mean, does that define the maximum of being nervous that final day at Q School?
It really was, actually. Most things are a blur to me now, where I used to remember every shot, but now it's just a total blur. But I remember it was six rounds of qualifying as the final, and we were playing the Nicklaus course the Nicklaus course in Palm Springs. In the 18th hole, I had about 170 yards of the hole, and it was a double green. And I hit a 4-iron to make sure I got over the bunker and over the water and left of the water and everything. I hit it to 60 feet. Problem was I had to two-putt to make it, and I knew it. And I did. I two-putt. I made about a six-footer to make the card. And
wow.
And I remember playing with Billy Mayfair, and he made a big putt on that hole, too, to make it. And we're both hugging each other. And for some reason, I wasn't as emotional as he was. I'm usually very emotional, but he was bawling his eyes out. And we made the tour, so that was really cool.
Talk about you've played tournaments recently, senior tournaments at Caves and BCC. Yeah. And we're Baltimore guys, so talk about how much you like those courses.
I love coming home, and I really love coming home and playing in a tournament.
And having fans.
It's just coming home. It's really a really neat feeling. And Baltimore Country Club was always one of my favorites, Five Farms. And in Kays Valley last year, I did have a good tournament. I was injured there. I had a really bad rib, and it held out for some reason. I don't know how, but I got it in and ended up finishing, I think, fifth or something, and had a good experience there. And we played Lowe's Island. I didn't play good at Lowe's Island, but really enjoyed coming back and playing in Maryland. I used to always love coming the old Kemper Open and right. and then Tigers event back in the day, and then the U.S. Open that was the one Rory won. So that was always fun, too.
You have been on our show before on Sports Maven Talk Golf. How much do you follow the University of Maryland sports overall?
Big time. You know, it's funny that I'm still not used to being the Big Ten.
A lot of people are.
But at the same time, the ACC back in our day when it was just eight teams, and basketball was the best.
Oh,
because
it was.
They had the home and homes. You knew when you went to Duke, they had to come to your house. Yeah. You went to Carolina, they had to come to your house. And that was really fun, and they were a great team.
Speaking of Carolina, just on Monday this week, we had Jeff Baxter, who was on that team with Len Bias in 86. We did an event, and, of course, he's the guy who won the game,
sure.
really, for
yeah,
Maryland. So we've been reliving 1986 a bit when things were great.
It's been a tough year for Maryland. It really has been. And then what a night last night with UMBC.
I didn't see it. I just read about it. Actually, I just saw it on the airplane. The highlights.
It was
the low
a miracle.
Lights.
It was a miracle.
UMBC, I mean, wow, over truly the number one team in the
right. So where'd you fly in from?
I was home in, I'm in Jupiter temporarily in Florida and came up to National.
Well, can we get your opinion just on Tiger's comeback? Do you find it miraculous he's been out this long and is able to play this competitive?
No, because I actually had there was two things that I thought that really was the key to Tiger coming back, and that would be, one, if he's out of pain, and he got out of that nerve pain and the pain of making a golf swing, he's still Tiger Woods. So that it was a biggie, and he's out of the pain, and then whether he was going to come back and not have the chip yips, and he doesn't have the chip yips, so he's on full bore, and he's actually hitting the ball. He's hitting the ball further now than he was before ever, and it's incredible how good he's playing right now. It doesn't surprise me because he is out of pain, and I did predict if he's out of pain, he's going to win a major this year, long before this is before he really started. I just said that he's still Tiger Woods, and that's a different animal than everybody else.
Let's talk about all the new young talent on the PGA Tour.
Mm-hmm.
It's incredible. Like, you know, 9 or 10 names pop up this year. You know, Patton, Kazir, and guys you really are not household names.
Right.
Is that all because of the satellite tournaments? And
yeah, the web.com and all the tours around the world are preparing, because really our tour is the world tour now. And they're playing in Asia, they're playing in Europe, they're playing in Australia, they're playing everywhere. And they're getting experience and they're ready to go. So the best of the best are qualifying. And you're going to see, I don't think you're going to see as many guys have these 30-year careers, 25-year careers, because there's such a fine line between making it success and failure and an injury away from falling off. But I will say that as good as these young kids are, not one of them is even close to when Tiger was Tiger.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Anything else?
From one Terp to two other Terps. Congratulations on making the Hall of Fame. This is a great.
No, I'm not in the Hall of Fame. He's in the Hall of Fame.
Okay.
I'm
getting
an honor.
You're in our Hall of Fame.
All right. That's right. That's right. Freddie, couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
Thanks, guys.
You're a prince.
Yeah,
and continue. Get healthy, too, and don't rush back.
Okay. Well,
you're
back,
still young.
Yeah.
You're still young.
Yeah. 61, so young.
You're still young.
All right.